And now, Lord, what wait I for? My hope is in thee. Psalms chapter 39, verses 7. Hey, Dandelion, and welcome back to your weekly Wednesday wellness check with your bestie, Dohi Sama. And before we get started, please take a deep breath with me and count down from 10. You ready? 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Hello, precious dandelion, and today let's meditate on our speaking habits. I'd firstly like to ask you, do you have a person you tell everything to? I mean, everything. Someone that you can run to at 3:45 a.m. to help you out in the time of crisis. Someone who will let you ugly sob with them even when your words are incoherent. Someone who provides you with the comforting reassurance that things will get better. Now, while yes, some of us are blessed to have close friends and family, I mean Jesus. The Lord truly is like your living, breathing diary. A death note, but he brings life and forgiveness and freedom. The goodness. The point is, the Lord is your safe space, okay? No matter what you tell him, he can handle it and he understands. The Lord made you, okay? Tell him, in all your ways, he acknowledged you. He proves this by dying for a guilty lover, who is us. I can be honest and admit, I have a hard time opening up, okay? People say that they don't judge you, but some do, all right? Some have offered solutions that claim I was crazy. People were not always honest when delivering back truths. So talking to God at first, it was hard. I felt as if he would judge me or call me crazy or tell me to stop victimizing myself. The Lord let me lay my petitions at his feet. When I get so happy about a blessing, he listens. When I'm sad because a situation threw a curveball, he listens. When I'm so angry, all I could do is cry, he listens. He collects every tear. He reassures me always of his care and understanding, even when I am wrong and get caught up in my own pride. He listens. He reassures. He corrects, but he never takes away his love. Sharing secrets is hard. Being open about your vulnerabilities, that's hard, okay? That is why we have a God. He knows what you are thinking, so sitting there with your lips closed gets you nothing, not even blessings, okay? Talk to God. Be honest about your affairs concerning your heart. Talking to God also shows us how bottled up we actually are. I have come to understand that talking to God truly helps me process. I have to let him know what is bothering me and why, okay? By the time the conversation is over, though, not only God, but I also truly know what the issue is, what the root of the problem is, okay? Be of good cheer. Be of good cheer. The Lord desires to have an authentically speaking bond with you in your own way, okay? People feel like they have to come to the Lord in a quiet, like, oh, thou art so great, King. Now, why, yes, he would love that. Yes, striving to have such an eloquent speech is nice too. A simple, hey, daddy, I'm upset. It's okay, okay? It's okay. Even a daddy, now look, patience word 5 seconds ago, but now it's hammer time, okay? He gets it. The Lord gets it. He gets you. He created you like that, okay? He made a version of himself and slapped your name on it. So be reassured. You have someone who is always there. Friends are nice. I have a best friend. Her name is Sugar Cookie. I love Sugar Cookie. My Foxy, I love my Foxy. I love my Papa Bear. Like, I love all of my close friends. They are amazing. Family is lovely. Just named them, all right? I got a squad deep. Do you hear me? Still, they are not God. And when I can't formulate correctly what I feel, or I need to just feel, there is someone there ready to be my healer, my comforter, my lover, okay? My friend. In a world where they try to oppress and silence you, let your voice ring high to the heavens above. Even if it's a silent cry, your Father in heaven, he always hears you, okay? So on today, please rest and don't be stressed, okay? Please be so gentle on your mental. And remember, you are doing so much better than you even know and believe, okay? So perk up, chin up, clap it up. Give yourself grace and space to process, all right? Just everything that's happened thus far. And then clap it up some more for making it halfway through another week of fighting it out in the thuggish, ruggish, holy streets, okay? Please remember to eat and hydrate. Believe it or not, those two things make you feel better as well, all right? And as you are going about your days and your nights, put your jackets on. It's getting cold out there, okay? Keep some Kleenexes in your pockets or close to your persons, all right? All right. Please do keep going. Keep fighting for yourself. Keep believing in yourself because you got this, okay? And the only way you're not going to get what you want is if you stop fighting for yourself. So with that being said, please always do remember, the Lord does love and bless you. May he keep you. I believe in you. I love you. And I hope whenever you view this, you have the most incredible of days or the most blessed, incredible of nights. Goodbye, guys.